Are Hawaii's airports up to par? Good evening and thanks for joining us. I'm Paula Akana. Now, it's still a mystery why power failed at the Kona Airport this week, shutting down runway lights and delaying a half a dozen flights. But it has prompted a closer look at problems at other airports. KITV4's Catherine Cruz has our top story.
There's still no clear indication why the backup generators failed during a two-hour power outage at the Kona Airport.
Right now, we're looking at what caused the problems and we're looking at how to address the issues.
KITV has uncovered that Hilo Airport was apparently in the throes of a similar situation on, of all days, September 11th of last year. A two-hour power outage from 2 a.m. to 4:30 a.m. was triggered during a test of an emergency generator. It prompted an airport official to write this. The situation prompted a serious safety operational issue, not just for airport officials and tenants, but for the traveling public as well. The facility would be open to security breaches. This would pose a huge security issue at night and in enclosed areas. There would be no lighting, no security cameras, no radio communications, no public address system, and the TSA X-ray screening machines would be useless, so screening would all need to be done by hand. Here in Honolulu, DOT officials are preparing to put a new $20 million backup generator system in place.
What this power plant will do is provide 55% of the power needs for the terminal so we can move the passengers off the island since they can't go back to their hotels.
It's a direct result of the weakness uncovered during the 2006 earthquake. A 9-hour power outage stranded thousands of travelers at the airport. Not only was there a safety issue, but a public health one. The state had just switched over to an electrical flushing system, so the toilets backed up. Visitors wondered why the state was so ill-equipped.
It would be a key thing to be able to move people off the island.
This new biodiesel facility is to go online this summer.
We try to power the reservation system so the airlines can continue to ticket the passengers. We power the baggage system so we can move the baggage to the airplanes and also the loading bridges so we can load the passengers on the plane.
And
the bathrooms.
This building here, located off Lagoon Drive, houses another bank of backup generators, but these are tied to the airport runway.
Because the runway is so critical, there's a second generator located near the FAA tower, a backup to the backup.
There's two generator facilities that each power half, but each can also take over the other half if one side fails.
The generators kicked in last April because of an electrical short in the runway lights. The problem was later tracked to runway lighting, which was found to be underwater.
So the state has begun a modernization program at the Honolulu Airport. Big Island lawmaker Cindy Evans tells us there is money in the budget to help with neighbor island airports, but those contracts have not yet been let. Back to you.